Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman will deliver her maiden budget tomorrow with a whole host of expectations from all stakeholders. So what does industry in India Inc. look forward to in the Union Budget? To discuss that, I'm joined by Sandip Somany, President of the FICCI. Mr. Somany, thank you so much for joining us on Bloomberg. Let me begin this conversation by asking you about, you know, the basic question of growth. The economy as we speak is faced with serious challenges, growth slowing down to 5.8%. What do you think needs to be the government's economic priorities, and how do you think that can be addressed in the budget?
So thank you for having me over. As all of you are aware, the last quarter's GDP numbers are 5.8%, which is the lowest in the last 5 years. And this is a matter of concern, actually of quite a serious concern, because until there is growth, the two problems that cannot be addressed are generation of employment and investment. So I think both these are urgently required to be triggered. And that is what the budget must focus on.
Mr. Somany,
ways to do it through a little bit of fiscal expansion. Mm-hmm. So the Honorable Finance Minister has the money available for these initiatives.
Okay. Let me push you on that FISC question once again. Talking at a time when there is significant pressure on the agriculture sector. I know fixing the farm sector is going to cost some money. The finance minister, many believe, does not have the fiscal headroom to pay these bills. Two questions. Where is the money going to come from? Or do you believe the time is ripe for perhaps the government to sacrifice fiscal prudence to attend to some immediate pressing issues of agriculture?
So let me answer the question on the money first. Mm. The government has been in the past few years divesting between 80 and 90,000 crores from central public sector undertakings. I believe that this target has to be significantly raised upwards to well in excess of 1,50,000 crores for the year. I believe that not only shares need to be sold, but also excess land with these PSUs, as well as ex-idle assets, factories, loss-making units, they all need to have a much more comprehensive policy in terms of disposal. So one source of money which is available for the government is this additional resource that they can easily get. And I personally believe that the agrarian crisis is quite serious, and we need to put in the resources to make sure that the farmers are well supported. And in that case, if the Honorable Finance Minister has to have some access to additional funds, the fiscal deficit going up by 0.1 or 0.2%, I don't think heavens will fall.
Okay. Point taken.
That latitude is there, and at this point of time, in my opinion, that's a better option.
Point taken, Mr. Somany. Every budget, you know, also makes announcements on, you know, new infrastructure projects. The reality is that infrastructure players today are funded by non-banking finance companies where there is a liquidity crisis. How do you expect the finance minister to address the liquidity crisis in the NBFC space?
So I think the liquidity crisis is a serious one, particularly in the recent months for the NBFCs. I think two things need to be done. I think interest rates are also at a lifetime high as far as India is concerned, real interest rates. They need to be brought down significantly by at least another 100 basis points. The RBI governor has made three cuts of 0.25% each, but unfortunately the transmission to the people who need it is poor, and the banks have not proportionately reduced the rate. So ultimately it has not had any effect in the economy, in the real economy. I believe there are more needs for cuts and more transmission needs to be put through. The cuts that are made needs to be transmitted to the users, which in turn will result in lower interest costs, and particularly to customers, which will result in lower EMIs for them, stimulating consumption.
We're also talking at a time, Mr. Somany, where there is global trade friction. We've seen the battle between China and the United States. India has also been at the receiving end from the United States quite recently. Do you expect the budget to address some intrinsic issues with respect to making our exports more competitive?
Well, I'm not sure how much the budget can do other than subsidize certain sectors of the economy. Mm. But really, we have to make India and Indian industry more competitive. And that is not really a discussion for the budget. That's a much broader subject, which in any case the government of India must focus on. Whereas we have significantly improved in terms of ease of doing business, I don't think we've improved in terms of cost of doing business. So, as I mentioned, our interest costs are very high. Our labor costs are very high in terms of when related to its productivity. So in isolation, labor costs in India are looking low, but the Indian labor is also among the most unproductive labor in the world. So ultimately, net-net, you are not cheap. Also, land prices are very high. And I think these factor costs need to be addressed, and these can be done off budget also. The government needs to seriously work in India in terms of bringing the cost of business down and making Indian companies globally competitive and helping them acquire scale.
What about corporate taxes, Mr. Somany? You know, while the government had committed to bring down the headline corporate taxation rate to 25%, do you think the government can actually deliver it on that one right now?
Well, if the government delivers a flat 25% corporate tax, of course, we will all be happy. But I have given, as FICCI President, a more pragmatic solution to the Honorable Finance Minister. And that links a reduction of corporate tax with generation of additional employment. And automatically, when you generate employment, you will automatically be investing. So it addresses the dual problems of lack of investment and generating new jobs. What I have suggested is if a company, for example, creates up to 500, between 250 and 499 jobs, then they will get from the plant starting, they will get an 2% income tax off for the next 5 years. Mm-hmm. If they create 500 to 790, 749 jobs, then they'll get 3% off. If from 750 to 999 people, 4% off. And if they create more than 1,000 jobs, then they will get 5% off their income tax for the next 5 years. So effectively, their income tax will come down to 25%. It's the same thing, but in this case, the government has a much more focused approach because they will only give the lower tax effect to people who are creating jobs.
Okay, so in a sense, you're saying let's incentivize job creation.
And that is the need of the hour, as all of us.
Sure. You're saying incentivize job creation at this juncture.
Absolutely.
And link it to some
Absolutely.
Sort of a like, tax rebate.
Exactly. We used to have, if you remember, in the old times, many times in the budgets, we used to have an investment allowance which used to give additional depreciation for new projects. I'm just trying to tweak the old formula to make it more relevant in today's day and world where the investment is not tagged, but the employable, the number of jobs you create is tagged for the incentive to be achieved.
Fair point.
And disbursed.
One area of concern
it's a more pragmatic formula.
Sure. One area of concern, Mr. Somany, has been in the area of corporate investments. Today, the chief economic advisor in the economic survey has emphasized time and again about increasing the level of investment in the economy, primarily led by the private sector. We haven't seen corporates invest. What do you think can be done in this budget to revive corporate investments?
So, the problem is which came first, the chicken or the egg. Mm. So India has had, with muted growth now, investments become a problem because the growth itself is falling and people have enough capacity. So Indian industry is working on about a 75-76% capacity utilization. So they have enough scope to tweak a little bit more productions and ultimately serve their customers. So ultimately the problem is they will start investing only when they see robust demand growth. And so demand growth has to be stimulated by the government rather than investment. Once the demand comes, the people automatically will invest because they all have to invest to keep their customers. Otherwise, customers move from, brand A to brand B.
One sector that has seen sustained demand slowdown has been in the area of the automobile sector. Are you anticipating any specific measures for the auto sector?
Well, I can't guess on behalf of the government, but I think that sector is in stress. If I saw the last month, June sales, there are very significant decrease in sales volumes. And I think that sector has a knock-on effect on a lot of sectors which supply into the auto sector. Mm. So I think if the government can do, if it has the fiscal latitude, they must help that sector out.
Okay. I have one final question, Somany, and this is with respect to, you know, we've spoken about what the government needs to be focusing on. What do you think the one or two things that the government should stay away from? What don't you want to see the finance minister announce in this budget?
Well, I don't know the correctness of this, but a lot of papers have been carrying articles on reintroduction of estate duty. I mean, I personally think, and FICCI believes, that this is the wrong kind of tax. It disincentivizes people to make money, and no country in the world. Firstly, it's also a developed country phenomena. We are still a developing country. No developing country in the world has this tax. And frankly, world history has proved that by making the rich poorer, you can't make the poor richer, frankly. So I think it's a retrograde tax, and I hope the Honorable FM does not impose something like this on in India.
We'll leave it there, Mr. Somany. Thank you so much for joining us. That's the view of FICCI. There's the president of FICCI talking about what to expect from the finance minister. We'll wait till tomorrow when the finance minister, Nirmala Sitharaman, presents her first budget. If you have been, thank you so much for watching.